Recovered after the war, this picture was taken by a camera on a Japanese plane the morning of December 7th. It's fuzzy and unclear, but some experts believe it's a midget sub firing a torpedo straight into Battleship Row.
To this point was roughly 1,600 feet. We have numerous torpedo tracks in the water.
Naval Intelligence Officer John Rodgard and forensic engineer Peter K. Sue have spent years analyzing this single photograph.
What we see in this photo is the effects of the initial aerial torpedo strikes against Battleship Row. We can see the concussion waves radiating out from the ships that have been hit. We can see torpedo tracks in the water. We see an object in the water with a distinctive horizontal feature and a distinctive vertical feature.
Both are features of a midget submarine.
The vertical feature would be the sail. The horizontal feature, the hull. We can see behind it plumes of water caused by a propeller.
Could those plumes of water be caused by a torpedo being dropped by an airplane?
No, because the torpedo hitting the water has a distinctive splash. It's a forward movement. This does not have that characteristic. It's more of a fountain effect caused by a propeller.
The propeller of midget sub number 5. Whenever a Japanese midget sub fires a torpedo, there's a sudden loss of balance.
A torpedo weighs about 1 ton. The sub weighs 46 tons. When a torpedo is launched, the forward part suddenly gets 1 ton lighter,
which in turn rocks the sub up and down as the crew struggles to regain control. This creates a unique plume of water called a rooster tail, which occurs when the propeller flies out of the water. But did the torpedo hit its target? The rooster tails in the photograph could offer a clue.
It generates a surface disturbance.
According to Sue, an expert in fluid dynamics, one of these rooster tails may also be the result of the midget sub torpedo hitting its mark.
This kind of animation.
Under John and Peter's guidance, NOVA has taken the team's original classified calculations and re-engineered them into revealing animation. When a torpedo blasts into a ship, it produces a shockwave, powerful enough to lift a sub out of the sea, even at a distance. The shockwave created by an airborne torpedo isn't powerful enough to reach the midget sub.
The area generated by the shockwave does not reach the submarine.
Because a torpedo fired by a midget sub has a warhead almost twice the size as an airborne one, the shockwave it creates radiates much farther. And when that torpedo hits its target,
cavitation extends beyond the submarine and lifts it above the surface.
But how does the animation compare with the original photograph?
What we see in the animation is the effect of the explosion on both the submarine and the large rooster tail. As we can see as a snapshot in time of the large plume behind the submarine in the photograph and the plume rising alongside the West Virginia. And the correlation is perfect.